those bitter nights without your sweet skin. And even with these tears that I cry, I still see that I'm behind this window, girl.
Renee.
I am so sorry I'm late. I thought I would beat you home.
Well, you gotta hurry, man. My dad's gonna be mad if we're late.
Even on your birthday?
Yes.
Doesn't he know it's supposed to be all about you? Huh? All right, come on.
Ooh.
We know Tony Jones isn't gonna be ready.
At least we know she's home.
Can we please listen to some music from the century?
Hurry up.
I know what I'm gonna wear.
That's how I feel for you.
What happened?
All these days with
Billy broke up with me today.
Not again.
He said that I wasn't doing enough work for the cause. And I'm like, it's midterms. You might be able to study and write 50 revolutionary poems at the same time, but I can't.
Calvin and I grew up with Malik, a.k.a. Little Joey Anderson. And you deserve so much better. But could you get dressed so we can go?
Excuse me. Well, I guess the birthday diva has spoken.
And he and his parents are already over there.
His parents, ugh.
Everyone calm down. If anyone trips, I'll take the heat.
Hey, babe.
Hey.
You're late. Your father's ready to have a heart attack.
Ladies.
Hi, Calvin.
Hi.
Livingston.
Hi. So glad you could come.
You look lovely.
Thank you.
Hi, Mrs. Livingston.
Hello.
You look beautiful. Oh, sweetheart. Oh, happy birthday.
Camille, how the hell are you going to be late to your own birthday party? I damn near had to push my last patient off the table just to be here on time myself.
I'm sorry, Daddy.
It was my fault, Dr. Livingston.
Actually, it was my fault. Today has been such a... Do you guys have any St. John's wort?
I am so proud of this young man.
Thank you, Dr. Livingston, but I'm still waiting to hear back from Howard and Mahari. Me and Pops are going to hit the road next week and check out all three.
That's right.
Well, those lesser institutions will certainly accept you.
Now, Al, why do you always have to go trash talk Howard?
But Thomas, you need to get over the fact that your son wants to be a doctor like me. And plus, Morehouse has the best school of psychiatry for when Cammie joins Calvin.
Yes. Well, Camille, I thought you were leaning towards social
I
work.
I wanted to take this opportunity to propose a toast to Calvin. Congratulations, sweetheart, on your acceptance to Morehouse.
I know everyone's hungry and we want to eat, but before we do...
Uh-oh. Take care, bro.
Here you are.
It's a box. It's a teeny tiny box.
Go ahead, open it up, sweetie.
Here it is, here it is.
No. It's a necklace.
Ooh, it's beautiful.
You're my heart. Now you're mine.
Thank you.
It's so beautiful.
Renee, I told you not to mention the social work thing in front of my parents or Calvin.
I'm sorry. I really wish that he was coming out with us tonight.
Yeah, I do too, but, you know, he says he still has a lot of studying to do, and he's actually trying to beat his dad's GPA.
Well, don't worry. We are going to have a great night.
Oh, Camille, I am gonna dropkick her butt back to the house if she doesn't stop sulking.
Look, Tony, Tony. Tell your girl what would make you feel better.
Well, I'm gonna feel a whole lot better when I read this poem loud and in his face tomorrow.
Well, what are we waiting on? We could just do it tonight. You know, we could go there before we even head downtown.
It's poetry night, right?
Oh. Come on, girl, it's your birthday, and you wanted to hit the clubs.
I don't know, I just think we should do it. You guys are silly.
I'm gonna get a soda. Do you want anything?
Oh, I'm fine.
Let me help you with that, miss.
You scared me. But thank you, I'm fine.
Yeah, I can see that. That's why I insist.
Wow. That's ancient.
Honey, it's been a long day, okay? And it ain't over yet.
Well, I hope that you get off soon so that you can rinse that tired Mac of yours.
If I was macking you, you'd know it, hon. What's your name?
Oh, please, don't be ridiculous.
And don't flatter yourself. It's Camille. Then you left your car on the pump, sweetie.
Oops.
And be careful about that kind of thing around here, Miss Livingston.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So that I don't stereotypically end up in the pen, I butcher you with the truth of my pen.
That's right. Ray. That's right, bro.
Peace. My name is Mad Rage.
Brothers and sisters, that was Mad Rage, and I am Malik, your host. And I think we need a little atmosphere. How about that? Y'all think we need some atmosphere? My man. Now, Mad is so free that he often inspires me to freestyle.
Oh, Lord, here we go.
Speak. Speak like a child who's allowed to speak. But yo, let me not upset the flow. And ask y'all to give me two snaps and many, many claps for the acoustic soul of Rain Sanders. Give it up for Rain, y'all.
She's amazing. I could never be this brave.
Since Rain is still tuning up, she said I could drop a quick one if y'all don't mind. Too black. Too strong. Too fake. Too wrong. Could you just be cool and colored? Colored and cool, fool. I know where you live. Know about the wealth you come from, running around like the wretched of the earth. Is that the same earth your parents play golf on? Where they park their Benz and their Jag while you wear politically correct rags? Fanon didn't ask you to dress like that. You can have what you have and still be black. Love black, live black. Doesn't have to be bold. And in all caps. I love the lowercase black in you, boo. And until you do too, then I guess you're right. We're through. Ladies.
That was tight. I knew you had to do that.
It's so fierce. I heard an angry Whitney Houston video.
But, you know, it was pretty. Fabulous.
Yes, it was.
Birthday girl.
Thank you.
Hey, how you doing? How you doing? Love. Oh, my God.
Now, which one's the birthday girl?
21.
Ooh. I'm at the table. I'm going to go grab it. All right, what are you drinking?
Iced tea.
Iced tea.
Okay. Hi, Camille.
Hi.
How strange.
I was thinking how nice. I'm Billy Ryan. Nice to meet you. Did I hear Thelma say it was your birthday?
Yeah, it is. Excuse me. I'll go find my friends now.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. It's your birthday. You gotta dance on your birthday. I mean, why else would you come out?
I'm sorry, but I have a boyfriend.
We can dance with us, too. All I know is I'm dancing.
Well, have fun.
Tourist boys letting you?
No, he's not a tourist. He actually pumped me earlier.
I mean,
he works at the gas station.
Hey, everybody. Roland's letting me set in for a song, so. This one's for Camille. Celebrating her 21st birthday tonight.
You never told me you knew Billy Ryan.
That's because I don't.
Thank you very much. Thanks, guys. Hi, girls.
Hey.
How about that dance now?
I'm sorry. We were actually leaving. We were just in the middle of midterms.
You guys go Xavier?
Mm-hmm. Why is it you know everything about me before I tell you?
Well, not only is the gas station across the street from the campus, but I pay attention. One dance. Come on.
I'm sorry. We have to go. Ladies.
Well, happy birthday, Camille.
Thank you.
I'm playing here next Sunday with Roland again, and I would, you guys should come. Y'all should come out and see it. I'd like that a lot. And, I guess that's it. If you gotta go, then you gotta go, right?
You gotta let go of my hand first.
Can I get your number first?
No, you can't. Good night.
Good night, Miss Livingston.
Is anybody hungry? I'm starving suddenly.
Last Saturday, we were talking about self-what? You guys remember?
Selfish, as in Tamika's a selfish little bitch.
Tomorrow, what did we say about using the B word, huh? Yes, Jerry.
I think it was self-determinacy.
Self-determination. That's right. Did anyone do the homework? Remember, I asked you guys to describe a goal, one that was really important to you, even if it wasn't cool to others.
Can I go?
Sure.
What I want us to be is a hairdresser.
Shocking.
Tamara, please.
I want to do hair because it's something I think I'm pretty good at, and I don't feel angry and nervous when I do it.
Shamika, that is excellent. Anyone else?
Could we talk about something interesting, like boys?
Okay. Can anyone tell me how boys and love relate to self-determination?
Hey.
Hey.
Somebody's got them wandering eye blues.
Oh, girl, please, don't say that. I just needed something to keep me awake.
So you could dream about Billy Ryan?
That's ridiculous.
Billy Ryan.
Stop saying his name.
Hey, are you still on Billy Ryan? Camille, last night you said...
It was a non-issue. Which is kind of a shame, because Billy Ryan got a little flavor happening.
Well, Billy Ryan is a non-issue. It's Renee here that's harping on it. And what's wrong with his name?
Well, now this may sound Alabama, but my mother always told me that there were three kinds of men to stay away from. Any man with the name Ray, men with small ears, and men whose first and last names are both first names.
Anyway, lover girl, being serenaded by one of New Orleans' young rising blues talents is a pretty sweet birthday present, if you ask me.
I'm not asking. Ladies, have a test in 4 hours. Calvin and I are together. I'll probably never even see Billy Ryan again. Let it go. And what is this thing about the small ears?
I'll take you somewhere fancy and you want to go to Cornbread Connection. I mean, the place is nice and all. It's just kind of, I don't know, country in there.
Calvin Dumas, you are becoming straight up and down bougie.
Straight up and down bougie? Cammie, I think you've been volunteering with those little roughneck girls for far too long.
I love those girls. And if you just stop by once or twice, you'd see why. I mean, not one of them has a healthy relationship with their father.
You're so depressing. I mean, one minute you're complaining that we never spend any quality time together. Now you want to guilt trip me about some underprivileged youth the night before I'm supposed to leave on this big trip?
Calvin, I'm sorry.
So what do you want to do? You want to go to the casino? Remember how we used to have to sneak in there when we first started dating?
Yes, I remember.
Maybe you should give me a little kiss first.
You know, I never realized what small ears you have.
What?
He's not fine. He's okay.
Yeah.
Can I get you two bottled water for me, please?
2 glasses of your finest champagne, please.
Coming right up.
Thank you. Hey, man. Excuse me. Can you come over here for a second? Hey, I'm sorry to interrupt you, man. I just had to tell you that was great. Just outstanding.
Thanks.
Really good.
Thanks a lot.
Do you want to join us? Grab a seat. Can we buy you a drink?
Why not? Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm Calvin, and this is Camille.
Hi. Billy Ryan. Nice to meet both of you.
Pleasure's ours. You play here often?
No. But I'm playing tomorrow night at a place called Thelma's. You guys should come by and check it out.
That's too bad. I'm not the performance. I'm just, I'm leaving town tomorrow, so.
Yeah, it's too bad.
But, you know, sweetheart, it's really getting late. Don't you want to get some rest before your trip?
But, babe, we just offered the man a drink. We can't be rude now.
You know what, man? It's cool. Some other time.
Sure?
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah?
Let me ask you a question. How long are you going to be gone?
About a week. Why?
Because I've got a gig in a couple of weeks at the Club Brass, and maybe you guys can catch that one.
Well, yeah, I'll definitely try to check it out, man.
All right.
That's cool. Let me just go take care of the waitress real quick, okay?
Excuse me.
Why did you do that? You could have said no.
I'll see you soon.
I was completely useless.
Quit looking at me like that before you get yourself in trouble.
Oh, so sweet. Yes.
Hey.
Hi.
What's happening, my sisters? How y'all doing today?
All right. How are you, Joe? Malik, how you doing?
I'm blessed, thank you.
We had the best day.
Yes.
We went out to the museum and they had a free jazz concert.
And you had a picnic.
Excuse me? my sister. Now, I know you're not using the word as archaic and oppressive as picnic, which comes from the term to pick a Negro as related to the phenomenon of public lynchings.
Urban legend.
Give it a rest, Malik.
Do you have any more picnic food left? I'm hungry.
No, but we're gonna cook a big meal. In a while.
Mm-hmm. Namaste.
Weird.
But I'm playing tomorrow night at a place called Thelma's. You guys should come by and check it out. You guys should come. Y'all should come out and see it. I'd like that a lot.
Great.
I'd like to introduce you to the legendary Roland Bracey.
Oh, it's an honor.
Lord, if I was as pretty as you, I'd look into the mirror and kiss myself 100 times.
Hi there. I love the fact that you came out tonight.
Surprise, Tom.
Nope. Just happy.
You're confident.
You are beautiful. What are you, I got a couple friends of mine that are playing at Club Brass right now. Can you go with me?
Where?
You're from New Orleans, you've been to Club Brass.
My mom is from here. I'm actually from Georgia. I didn't move here until I was in junior high.
So you've been here 10 years. You still don't know where Club Brass is. That is pitiful.
Okay, I admit, I'm a sheltered geek. You can't hate me for that.
I'll never hate you. But you do need some schooling.
Hey, what's up?
What's going on, man?
How are you, man?
What's your first set tonight?
Yeah, yeah, let me introduce you to somebody. Goodbye, Camille.
Hey, Camille, how you doing? Pleased to meet you.
All right, man, knock it out.
Hey, Tom, won't you let me sing with you tonight?
What's up, everybody? Welcome to Club Brass.
Uh-huh. Let's get this party started, y'all. Come on.
Yeah. They gonna get it again. The dirty sound. Uh-huh. Non-stop. Up front. 2000.
Come
what on. Y'all know about this boy here?
Come on.
Uh-huh. Akon.
Come on.
None of y'all cats got food. So what you know about how we do? I crashed in the spot with my food. I got mad clout. Why don't you make your girl pass out? Underestimate these streets. Your man a player, hate and blast your feet. God say you cast me, you in too deep. Better do anything just to eat.
Well, what you know about
this boy?
Come on.
What you know about this boy?
Come on.
What you know about this boy?
Come on.
What you know about this boy?
Come on. Go take it.
Why'd you hold on to me like that?
Come on, you're exaggerating. I just got a little carried away.
Well, you should get carried away more often. It's like this little polite Catholic schoolgirl turned into Aretha Franklin. You have an amazing gift, Camille. No one's ever told you that before?
Do you have a record contract in your pocket or what?
No, nothing like that. I don't understand walking around with this voice and not doing anything about it.
I sing in the gospel choir.
Of course you do.
What?
Nothing. You sing in the gospel choir. That's so you. Very sweet. You know, me and you can have a lot of fun together.
You're relentless.
All I'm saying, now's your chance. I mean, your boyfriend seemed cool and everything, right? But to me, he seemed a little stiff as well. And I'm willing to bet my paycheck that he's never taken you to Boulder's, huh? Or Soul Kitchen. Or Cubanos.
No, but I don't think that's a good idea, okay?
I understand. Say, what are you doing tomorrow night?
I've been waiting for this all week long. Gotta get up. Party on, call my crew, hit up all my friends, cause I'll be rolling and holding it down. In my Gucci gear, looking hot tonight. I see you breaking the neck cause the Benz is tight. I'ma pull up to the front of the line, cause I'm about to make y'all move. Hey yo, everybody in the club, get on the floor and make the party come. Tell the DJ we gon' wake it up, ain't no standing on the wall. See the party ain't gon' never stop. So everybody wake the collar pop. We keep it rocking till the break of dawn. Ain't no standing on the wall. Yo, they're testing the club, cause they packing them in. They say you're feeling this joint, so we gon' play it again. If your pockets are fair, then you're VIP. There's only players and ballers with me. Fellas, go get your girl, ladies, go get your man. Now put your cup down, because it's time to dance. Hey, you over there, get up out of your chair.
But you can sing and dance, girl. You're on fire tonight. Just ask Hector.
I think it was those boots that put a spell on you.
I had another amazing night. I mean, I feel like I'm on vacation in my own city. I just wanted to say thank you. Thank you so much.
I guess I better get going. Do you want me to walk you to your door? I can't believe you have this album.
The vinyl was actually Tony's.
This was my dad's favorite album.
Mm-hmm.
He used to wake me up every morning playing the saxophone.
So, is your dad a jazz musician?
Not really. He's more of a, like a jazz head. You know, he used to play in funk bands and R&B bands.
You know, that's the first time you've ever mentioned either of your parents.
You gotta listen to this.
It's nice. Look, I think it's really cool that your dad is so hip. I'd like to meet him one day.
Well, if you're ever out in L.A., you should look him up. He's probably playing some little dive joint out there. Willie Gallo.
Gallo? Where does Ryan come from?
Ryan's my middle name.
Oh. Oh, that's great.
What? What do you mean?
It's silly, but my roommate believes that you can't trust any man whose first and last name are both first names.
You gotta be kidding me.
No, or any man named Ray, or any man that has small ears. But you have really nice ears.
Is that right? You know what else they say? They say you can't trust a woman with a cute nose. Or high cheekbones. And definitely not perfect lips.
So what about your mom? Where does she live?
Mom lives in Lafayette.
You see her a lot?
No, once or twice a year.
A year? Gosh, I can't even imagine that. My mom and I talk every day. On the other hand, my father, we see each other all the time, but we don't talk very much. Unless he's drilling me on some pre-med stuff.
Pre-med? I thought you were gonna do the social work thing or something like that.
Well, a psychiatrist is what I'll be. And I guess it's the best of both worlds.
Wait, is it? I mean, I don't want to, I mean, I, it just, it sounds to me like you're just doing it to please your pops.
You've never wanted to please your parents?
I mean, it'd be kind of impossible, you know? My dad doesn't care, and my mom, you can't even have a decent conversation with the woman. I mean, she just rants. She hates my dad. She blames him for her miserable life. I'm not big on family. Check out this Segway.
You are so beautiful, but I can't kiss you yet.
Yet. That's promising.
Not just yet, not ever. And you know, I don't think we should be listening to that.
Hurry up! Get down
here. Come on. You gotta see this. Ooh. Come on. Come on.
Renee, you are so bad. Quick, hurry up.
What time is it?
Almost 7.
Hey.
Billy.
I gotta go. I gotta get to work. I'm gonna be late.
Billy.
I'll call you a little bit later. Ladies.
Matt.
Bye.
Another late night study session. So, you're doing your thesis on the blues now, too?
Look, Camille, I do think that you were getting it over your head, but Tony, you have no right to talk.
What is that supposed to mean?
You and Malik. I mean, you guys are like the black Tommy and Pamela Lee. And if this is what love is all about, then I'm glad I'm not in it.
Love?
Mm-hmm. I mean, I listen to some music with a friend. I just love the way you pick the week that your man's out of town.
Sorry, I have to agree with Renee. It's a little slippery.
We listen to some music. We had a good time and nothing happened. Tony, he even likes your record collection.
And whose are these?
These are mine.
Wow.
Look, if this is your walk on the wild side slumming fantasy thing, then good. You know, get it out of your system now. But just be careful.
Camille, have you even considered the race thing?
No.
Because brothers are going to be serving up mad grief if you get serious with Billy.
Okay, A, she's not going to get serious with Billy. And B, who cares about the race thing? I just don't know how you're going to explain bringing home a gas-pumping, non-degree-having, broke blues musician.
I resent the fact that I'm having to defend him to you. He worked hard so that he's not broke.
Okay, Camilla Rilla, it's just, I just want you to consider what you're getting into. I mean, what's up with this?
I don't know. With Billy, it just feels, I don't know. I don't know.
I don't know.
Yeah. So let them say it's wrong for me to love you. And they could never feel the way that I do when we kiss, when we're close like this. And they can't see inside my soul. Tells me what to do. It's what my heart knows. And that's the only truth I know is real. All I know is what my heart says to me.
Would you like to
what
come
in? What are you
in?
Doing, Camille?
Sorry. Excuse them, please. They seem to think that you and I are, you know. But I told them, stop being so dramatic. I mean, we're just friends.
Yeah, you know what, Camille? I'm not really feeling the just friends thing. I don't think you are either.
I know you got a boyfriend, but I have all this. I'm every night, I'm dying to take you in there and kiss you and feel you.
Oh, Billy, you know I can't do this.
How'd you like to sing in a blues band?
What?
It's the only thing I can think of to channel all this. I got some guys that I'm putting together, and I would love it if you sang with us. And every song that I'm thinking about playing these days, I put your voice to it anyway.
You think you can just say all of that, spill all of that out, and then ask me to be a blues man? You gotta be kidding. You are so out of line.
I'm out of line, huh?
Yes, you are.
Really? Why, because I say what I feel instead of worrying about what everybody else feels? Is that it? You gotta live your life, baby.
Baby.
Sweetheart. Shaddy. Darling.
You are very bad.
Yes, I am. You know what? I'm okay with being bad.
Okay. I'll sing with you guys. It's Calvin. Thanks. Hi, Billy. Hi, sweetie.
Hey, babe. I'm going to tell you, rehearsal.
Yeah.
So I'll let you know about rehearsal.
We already went to one. We just got off the road for like 3 hours, but we went to this little restaurant.
Okay. Sorry. Malik, we need to go study.
No, I'm paying attention. It's just Tony and Malik. Exactly.
I've been thinking about you, Kane.
You are? I was just thinking about you, too.
Ugh, remember that bike.
Mom!
Hey, baby. So what brings you around so early this morning?
I just wanted to talk to you guys. Where's Dad?
Tennis. He's been practicing like a madman while Thomas is away. So you heard from him?
Yeah, I talked to Calvin last night. But Ma, I want to ask you something. What did it feel like when you first met Dad?
Wow. Well, he was dating his high school sweetheart from Georgia at the time. Dorothy Fairchild. And boy, was she ever her namesake. Lighter than Lena Horne. Anyway, your dad and I had chemistry lab together. Sophomore year, Dorothy's mother got sick, and she had to go back home to Georgia.
Oh, how sad.
Oh, that's right. It was just a shame. By then, I was so out of my mind in love with them that I actually took to helping him write her love letters.
No, you didn't.
Yes. Pathetic, but true. It was around Christmas time, and we met outside at the cafeteria. I was so excited about the masterpiece I had written that I started reading it right there in line. We got to the soda machine. I turned to him, looked him right in the eye, and read him the last line. The taste of Mama's dressing, the smell of Christmas pie. I thought these things were home to me until I looked into your eyes. Check you out. He grabbed me and kissed me just right there in front of everybody. I mean, root beer just everywhere. And we've been together ever since.
Whatever happened to Dorothy?
Your father's parents adored Don. And his mother almost had a stroke when your father brought me home.
Why wouldn't they like you?
Because I was darker than this brown paper bag. Back then, if you didn't pass that simple test, ancient history.
Shouldn't you be in school, young lady?
Hey, Daddy.
Child, can't you see I'm a sweaty mess? I thought I told you to sell that scooter. It's dangerous, Camille. I don't want to see it in my driveway again.
Hey, darling, here's your breakfast.
I'm gonna have to take this to go. I'm late for my 10 o'clock. Now, I hope I'm not paying all that tuition for classes you're not even attending. When I was pre-med, we wouldn't think of being late, much less miss a class.
No, I don't have class until noon.
All right, I'm out. Oh, honey, can you start using proper language? You know, you're grown now.
Please. Love you.
And where did you get that awful hat from anyway?
See you later.
Hey.
Hey.
You're early. Come in.
And Gustavo's gonna be late. Which sucks because Jason's got to be out of here by 6. And I had a whole other arrangement for this song last night, and now I can't find it. I had it all figured out before I went to bed. All night. What? Say it's your parents' house. You don't have to be all proper. Just grab a seat anywhere. There it is. I found it.
I came early hoping that we could talk. I see it's a bad time, so I'll just leave, okay?
Wait a minute. What is it? Clear this off. Here, have a seat. I'm like, oh, I'm just hyper because of rehearsal. I get excited, but you can always talk to me.
I decided to change my major.
To music? That's excellent.
No, from pre-med and psychology to social work. Oh. And I went over this morning to talk to my dad, but of course he didn't have time. Then I got all excited thinking about coming to see you and just knowing that you listen and you...
What? Sorry.
I said, you ass.
Oh, Camille Livingston just said ass.
Come on, this isn't funny. I'm cracking up a little bit here.
Musicians, man, suck it up. You know, that's why I play solo.
You don't.
What? We got an ass. We're gonna get some more stuff here? What?
Come on, don't do that.
Look, I don't know anything about changing majors, but I do know this. I know that it's a good thing to commit to something that you want. And then you figure out a way to make it work for you. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. I gotta talk to you about something now, though. Okay? And then I gotta get back to this before the guys get here. It's about that hat.
What's wrong with it?
Well, I am loving it. Come on. Right, I know that, but the thing is that you gotta bring your own vibe to it. You know, you gotta bring the gospel to it. You gotta bring the brass to it. You know, and the Afro-Cuban. You know. And I'm telling you, man, I think we got a chance to do something really hip and soulful here.
you're very graceful.
Well,
good. I'm serious. I mean, you communicated and listened. It was really something to see.
I think you're exaggerating a little bit.
Oh, okay. And I'm the one that can't take a compliment, right?
Well, thank you.
You want to try some of this out? I want to take you someplace.
Yeah, bro, just put it out right there, man. You be all good.
Sup, Malik?
Hey, how you doing, my sister? What's going on?
What's going on, man?
So, where's Brother Calvin this evening?
I thought you said that he was arrogant and that he was a sellout and I should leave him.
Oh, okay. Chill, my sister, chill. I'm just looking out for my Nubian brother's interest, that's all.
Mm-hmm.
So, I think I need to see your student ID.
Not a student here.
I didn't think so. Now, Camille, you know this is a student-sponsored event and a student-sponsored cafe. Now, you can perform by yourself, but I don't know about your little friend here.
You just had those Cash Money boys in here. They're definitely not Xavier's students.
You know what? Forget about it.
No, I'm not gonna forget about it. This shouldn't even be a problem.
Yo, Malik. Yo, man, what's the problem, man?
What's up, bro?
Hey,
Malik,
man.
Is the problem.
Dude, don't push me out of the way.
Billy Ryan here is the problem, bro.
Billy Ryan?
Yeah, Billy Ryan.
Man, just forget about it, all right?
Billy? Billy Ryan?
What?
Skip!
What's up, man? What's up, man?
God dang, how'd you get so big?
Lifting all them beer mugs over there at Aunt Thelma's what started it. How you doing, man?
I'm doing good, man. I want you to meet somebody. Camille, this is Thelma's nephew, Skip.
How you doing?
I'm fine.
Dude, everybody call me Mad Rage around here, all right?
Oh, I'm sorry.
All right?
I'm sorry. You still doing the poetry thing now?
Yeah, yeah. I'm trying to finish up in college, get that degree, you know.
All right, cool.
Thank you, Malik.
All right, my man. Take it easy.
I understand Aunt Thelma practically got you playing at her spot every night these days.
Yeah, man.
All right?
You gotta
staying
come
busy?
By and check
yeah.
it out.
It's what my heart feels that tells me. It tells me what to do. It's what my heart knows. And that's the only truth I know is real. All I know is what my heart says to me.
Let them say that I'm a fool to fall so deeply. 'Cause they will never ever be loved so completely. How can they even talk that way? They can't see you through my eyes. They can't feel this love inside. All their words don't mean nothing. They can't change the way I feel. Yeah.
Billy.
What? Wait a minute. What are we doing here?
I don't know. Look, I'm sorry, okay?
I mean, we're supposed to be channeling here. Camille, I mean, I just channeled my ass off in there, you know? What do you...
I don't know. I just mean when we were in there and then out here and then... Oh, look, I'm confused, okay?
No, you're not, Camille. No, you're not confused. You're scared. Look at me. Tell me you don't know who you really want to be with. Tell me.
I do know.
Missed it.
No, you guys missed it.
What?
Ida's. Billy and I sang open mic night.
You're kidding.
No, and everybody loved it, except, of course, your boyfriend, who had a major attitude.
In case you haven't noticed, I'm home on a Friday night eating ice cream and watching Love Jones for like my 87th time.
Thanks a lot.
I am through with Malik for the last time.
Oh, really? What a relief.
You know, it is. It was just a big 1960s black arts movement myth with Malik. The wannabe revolutionary poet formerly known as Joey Anderson. And eventually you gotta blow out the incense and deal with reality.
Huh? But no. Like the idea that Calvin and I are supposed to be together. You know, the myth that every woman wants a handsome black doctor to marry her.
I do. I mean, I would like it if he wasn't quite as bougie as Calvin.
Well, I decided something tonight. I'm in love with Billy Ryan.
What?
And I want to be with him.
Wow.
And as soon as Calvin gets back, I'm gonna
You're supposed to be marrying Calvin.
Why?
Because that's the plan. Look, right? Isn't that what happens in rich people's families? You marry other rich people. And Calvin actually happens to be a pretty nice rich person. He's been very good to you.
Is that because he buys me nice gifts? You don't understand what Billy gives me. I mean, he's performing for the girls tomorrow at Willow House. For the last 2 years, I've been begging Calvin just to stop by.
That's really cool. And you know, Camille, I dig Billy. But I just always thought you were really touched by how well Calvin and your father got along.
Well, yeah, I am.
Okay. So how is Dr. Livingston gonna get along with Billy Ryan and his folks? I mean, who are the Ryans? Do you know? Do they know you? I'm down for you, Cam. I just really feel like you gotta think about these things.
Mm-hmm. Well, Ryan is his middle name, by the way. But no, I don't know his family. He's not that into family.
Oh, well, that makes you really compatible.
Calvin is the one with the small ears.
Okay, whatever, with my mama's Bama tail. Now listen, you know Calvin. Now that's solid. That's a lot more solid than your little, what, two-week-old rock and roll interracial fantasy.
Okay, everybody, listen up. I need you guys to continue to be on your best behavior because Camille has a very special guest today, okay? Okay.
See? And did you know that you can write part of a blues song by just using two sentences?
You ready?
Okay. They call me Offbeat Billy, 'cause I can keep my time straight.
Then just repeat it.
They call me Offbeat Billy, 'cause I can keep my time straight. The minute I found the woman of my dreams, I found out she had another date.
I just love those girls, you know? I don't want to be in a lab somewhere testing the latest antidepressants.
Oh, man, there goes my hookup.
But that's what I wanted to tell my parents tonight. Then Calvin comes back tomorrow, and of course I have a lot to tell him. It's just gonna be an intense weekend of confrontations, and I'm scared as hell.
You need a mojo.
I'm sorry, a mojo?
Yeah, I'm serious. It's something that, you know, something you can wear or put in your pocket, you know, like that. Something that means something to you, that it'll remind you of what you want. Mojo.
Well, I don't think you could fit in my pocket. Billy, this is it. This is it. You made up all this. I'm a light switch, like switch. Don't tell me I'm
wasn't that bad. You ready?
Show it to me.
I'll use it as my mojo secret.
That's what I'm talking about.
Thanks, Cindy.
She spells it with an S.
Mm-hmm.
Come back if you want the other thing.
Okay.
What other thing?
Nothing.
What other thing?
Nothing.
Hello? Where are you guys? Thought we were having dinner tonight.
Surprise!
Look how sweet.
We decided to come home early because there's so much to celebrate.
Look at you. You're so excited. You're speechless.
I want to let you all know that I had an incredible trip. I made a lot of very important decisions. First, I'd like to toast my father, who took time out of his extremely busy schedule to take me on this critical professional and personal journey. And Dr. Livingston, who's been such a profound influence on me and a true mentor. I think you'd be very pleased with my school decision. But I'll get to that a little later.
Well, thank you.
And finally, Camille, most beautiful girl in the world. Would you make me the proudest, happiest man alive and be my wife?
Excuse me, I'm gonna be sick. I think I can do this.
Oh, sweetie. It's only natural to be so nervous. Just think how magnificent your wedding day is gonna be. You know, this is gonna be the wedding that your father and I never got to have.
Ouch.
That hurts.
Camille, what is going on?
It was supposed to give me strength and courage because I needed to talk to you guys tonight.
You guys all right? Here, I brought you some water.
Thank you, Daddy.
Calvin decided on Morehouse, baby. Isn't that wonderful?
Yes, Daddy, that's wonderful.
Baby, the most wonderful thing in the world is that you found yourself an outstanding husband. I am so proud of you.
Well, Alfred Livingston, I don't think I've seen you this happy in almost, what, 20 years?
Well, I can't deny it, Evie. I'm thrilled. And I think you have something to say to Calvin.
Where are they?
Baby, you okay?
Yes, I'm okay. Yes. Yes, I need the number for the Times-Picayune Society page.
All night, man.
You owe me $20, fool.
Hey, you got my message.
Hey, guys.
Hey, come on in. We're just going over.
Hey, Billy, can I talk to you for just 1 second? Please.
Don't be too long now.
Yeah.
Gentlemen, carry on.
Oh, aye.
He'll never be back now.
Might as well pack up. He's lost. We won't get anything done.
Hey!
What's up? What's going on? Yo,
Sammy, give me a hand. I can't rehearse with you guys tonight.
Oh. Well, I mean,
It was impromptu anyway, it's no big deal.
Well, it shouldn't be impromptu. You know, you have something really amazing happening in there. And it's something you're passionate about. Why would you treat it so casually?
You come all the way over here to tell me that? I take it didn't go well last night. Is that, they didn't go for the whole social work thing, huh?
No. I didn't even bother to bring it up. You know, I just feel that I can counsel girls being a psychiatrist, just not these girls, you know. And I'll probably be in med school for a billion years first, so I just decided it was okay how it is.
Wait a second. Did that make any sense here? What's going on? Did you see Calvin?
I did.
And? And you said yes, Camille? Is that what you did? What? That's crazy!
No, Billy. You and me is crazy. This is crazy. You know, me and Calvin, that's normal. You know, you should have seen my dad. He was so, so happy. But look, Billy, I want you and I to still be friends. You know, I can't do the music thing with you anymore, but...
Okay.
I'm just so grateful.
Just quit! All right? I don't even want to listen to you right now. I can't even recognize your voice.
You know...
Just quit! Just go.
I am so, so sorry.
Yeah, I know, Camille. You're always sorry. That's like a permanent state with you, huh? All you do is tap dance and tiptoe and do whatever it takes to make anybody else happy but you. You know what, Dutch? You're right. It is sorry. It's sorry as hell. And it's weak as hell. I don't have friends that are that weak, so... I don't want to be your friend. You know what else I can't understand? Is it how somebody so weak has the strength to carry around a rock that big, Camille? Huh? How do you do that? How do you carry around all that weight?
It must be nice, huh? The luxury of not being connected to anybody.
Girl, I know we said we'd always be girlfriends, yeah. But in life we know all good things come to an end. When you say goodbye and you just move on, and you ask yourself why, you just might even break down and cry, and you wonder why you're leaving, yeah. It's gonna be now I know I was wrong for some of the things I said, yeah. But when your love's on the rocks, sometimes you just lose your head. Then you start to swear, you might get mad. Or when there's someone else around, seeing this fight just makes it bad. And you wonder why you're leaving, that's why I know.
You are cordially invited to the celebration of the engagement of Camille Livingston and Calvin Dumas.
Wow, this is some engagement party.
fight you for the cute one. Hurry up, sweetheart. The photographers are here. Oh, there they are. Get closer together, you two. Smile. Look at my baby.
Calvin, this is exhausting.
Gotta hold yourself, Cammy. There's some very important people here. I need to make a good impression.
Something doesn't feel right.
Duh, I've been saying that all week.
Okay, with the attitude, because I didn't exactly see you protesting this engagement.
Renee, that's because you've been pushing her on Calvin like a hustler trying to sell a cheap gold chain.
All right, look, us arguing isn't gonna solve anything. What are we gonna do? End of discussion, Calvin. Here she comes. Hey, ladies.
Hey. Having fun?
Calvin said I should eat something so I could get my second win.
Well, are you okay?
Yes, I'm fine. One of those things, you know, this is hectic.
Look, Camille. Look, I just... Okay, I feel like I've been pushing you to do the expected thing, and I feel terrible.
Why would you feel terrible at such a lovely party?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's an honor for me to be here with you on this very special afternoon.
Camille, I know that this is probably terrible timing. But tell me something, are you sure about all of this? Because if you're not, you just say the word and I can get the truck and we can get out of here.
So perhaps we can persuade her to join us for a tune. Miss Camille, would you honor us?
They want you to sing.
Hello. I'm so nervous. Here it goes, Calvin. This one is for you. Everyone that listened. You know, since this is called an announcement party, I have an announcement of my own to make. I am not in love with Calvin Dumois, and judging from his lack of interest in my song, he doesn't love me much either.
Cammy, you've had too much to drink. Why don't you come down?
No, Daddy, I'm not drunk, and I'm not finished.
Come on, Cammy, you're making a fool of yourself.
And I hate it when you call me Cammy. You know, that's my father's name for me.
And Calvin, you are not my father, even though you act like him more and more each day. I'm in love with a man who really sees me. And Mama, he is straight up and down Christmas pine and Mama's dressing. Mom, Dad, I love you guys, but I've got to go now. Ladies.
Finish this and then I gotta get to practice. Thelma's giving the band a shot and I got 2 weeks to put a set together. All right, so I don't appreciate this distraction. And if you're not here for some gas, I'd like you to go.
I came to show you this. You were right. It was too heavy. All of it, Billy, you were right.
For real?
Daddy, would you please talk to me?
You collect all these balls, and yeah, we can talk.
No, Daddy.
You know, you just can't do things like that, Cammy. Those are my colleagues. And your family, and my friends.
It was terrible. But committing myself to someone for the rest of my life, someone that everyone else loves except for me, would have been worse. You know, Mom told me that Grandma and Grandpa did not want you to marry her.
That was a different world, Candy. We're all past that now. My parents, they were...
They were wrong. You had to run away to get married. You had to defy your parents to be happy. I deserve to be happy, too. With school, with work.
And with the person that I love.
So, who is this fool young man breaking up my family?
His name's Billy Ryan.
Oh, Lord. You had to go and find you a real country brother.
No. He's white.
He's white?
Yes, and he's a blues musician.
Cameron, what am I gonna do with you?
Love me.
Always, baby.
Sweetheart,
I'm so glad you made it.
I'm working on your father.
It's okay. I'm not worried about him.
Oh, yeah? I swear the two of you are like two peas in a hard-headed pod.
Billy.
So, this is Billy Ryan.
It's a pleasure to meet you, man. Oh.
Is that your mom? You invited her?
Yeah, I wanted you guys to meet. You made it.
Don't act so surprised. Hi. Hey, darling. Hello, how are you?
Camille, Miss Livingston, this is my mom, Mavis.
It's so nice to meet you. Won't you join us? You know, I hear your son is very talented.
Well, let's hope so.
A warm welcome to Billy Ryan and his band. Give it up for him.
Well, Mom, gotta go. Love you.
Thank you. Thank you. We got a special night tonight. Tonight we're gonna debut a new band. That's right. I'd like to give a special shout out to my mom for accepting my invite tonight. It's been a while. Maybe we can change that. I'm glad she's here because she's gonna hear this next singer. Ladies and gentlemen, the lovely and the amazingly talented Camille Livingston. Put your hands together, guys. This is her first time here. Come on out.
Thank you. This is a song we've been working on for a while. It's a love song.
Completely, how can they even talk?
see you through my eyes. They can't feel this love inside. All their words don't mean nothing. They can't change the way. See you.